What's up, it's Meytal. Today we are going to watch together The Outsider by a Perfect Circle, which is officially, well, my cover of it, not just the music video, but yeah, my cover of A Perfect Circle, The Outsider, which was my very first official drum cover that I've ever uploaded. The first one me and Lior ever shot together. Me and Lior shot many videos, but this was the very first one. This little format is a part of the watch party that I started with Electric Violin, the Toxicity cover. So if you missed that one, you can go back and watch it. But yeah, this one was the official first drum cover. The first one that kind of started my YouTube career, if you can call it that, was the Electric Violin one. And after that, I got so many messages from people asking for more, and I couldn't really get more happening with Jen and Christine. And Lior said, "Let's just shoot a drum cover." And that was, I was learning at the time this song, and it was pretty much ready. And so we decided to shoot this video. At exactly the same time, I got a new kit. It's not my kit. You know how like sometimes life just magically like everything comes together, so some other thing might be possible. I feel like this whole thing was really my career was set up in this way because before this I had my Thomas Starr Classic. I had like two cymbals. One of them was broken, like two crash cymbals. It was not really a very impressive setup. And then I somehow, I don't even remember how, was introduced to soul tone cymbals, and they also had DC California, and they had these amazing drums. And they lend me the whole thing. They lent me the cymbals, they lend me the drums. So these are not mine. And a lot of my beginning, the first videos that you see, I have different kits, and everyone's like, "Is this girl like extremely rich? Why does she have a different kit in every video?" But it really just worked out that way that they wanted to promote their stuff, and I, had one video that had like 3 million views, and I was pretty confident that I could do it again. I don't know, but they hooked it up, and that was really crucial at that time for me because I never played such good gear. So later I went a different path from soul tone. I kind of felt at some point like they weren't really supporting my career in the way that I wanted them to. I don't know, everything was on loan. Like they did, I don't know, I felt like weird. I can't exactly remember the conflict, but then at the same time, I got an email from Don Lombardi from DW, which invited me, and it just also happened right at the right time where I felt like I needed to move on, and it all kind of just magically worked out. All right, let's start watching this video, which was the first video we shot. It was actually shot with a zoom camera. Do you guys remember those little zoom cameras that were like the first social media camera, like right when YouTube started being a thing? And Lior, literally, I practiced the song note for note. Back then I learned note for note because I didn't have a flow. I didn't know what was going on, so I really had to practice the song a lot and exactly, like it wasn't like now I can hit this cymbal, I can hit that one. It doesn't really matter. Like I know that I need to hit a cymbal, but back then it was like, okay, this cymbal is where I'm hitting here, and that cymbal I'm hitting there, and I'm like practicing it exactly, just exactly. So this is why we were able to do these videos, because today I have a bunch of cameras all around me, and I'm recording it live, and then you know, it all comes together and it's actually live. What you hear is what you see. But here we actually recorded it separately. Like we recorded one take and then shot the same cover from many angles. So if you play it not exactly the same way, I don't know if you guys really understand what I'm saying, but if unless you play it exactly the same, like you can't hear a cymbal but not see me hit a cymbal. So I had to play it just exactly right and in the same way every take. For the trained eye, you could probably see, and I'll point out when we start watching this video, I'll point out what doesn't look live, you know, just things like my hair, my smile, singing, or maybe there's some mistakes because some videos do have mistakes. We all got better with time, so all right, I'm excited to watch it. Let's check it out. All right. Ooh, such a good song. For instance, like look at this, these two shots, okay? Look how I'm like headbanging in the first and then in the other one, not so much. Check this out. Do you see this? Or is it just me? Like hair forward and then in the other one, chilling, no hair. And just in the transition, you're able to see this. I'm impressed with the audio quality, honestly, of the drums, considering we recorded literally with one good microphone. I remember Lior had one condenser microphone, I think, for the overhead and maybe another one for the bass drum. And it sounds good. I don't know how, but it really sounds pretty good. Now, again, with the live aspect of things, you see these closer shots that are coming from behind like this, but you don't see any cameras. This doesn't make sense because right after this shot you go in the front and you see that there is no one behind me, and you know it's a really close-up shot, but it looks cool. So I was 25 or 26 here. How old was I? 26? I don't know. You could see I'm not as comfortable. I'm like not really smiling. It was like an awkward experience the first time around. Although there are different shots you'll see, I think I was getting more comfortable as the song was progressing or as we were doing more takes. And then I started like smiling or singing and... but yeah, I remember some I remember one comment, you know, sometimes someone says something really insulting and it just kind of sticks with you. Someone was saying that I play like I was tied to a tree. And I really can kind of see what he was saying because my technique was just like, okay, my arms are not moving from the side of my body. I still have this, but now I think I have a little bit more concept of like you need to actually move your arms to have more power. But it looks pretty good. Like considering it was so long ago, I think I did a pretty good job and I look like I know what I'm doing. So good job, 26-year-old Meytal. I'm so jealous of my hair. It was so healthy and long, and I look just really young. Lior used an earthquake effect right there, and I feel like it was like the only time we did it, but it's really cool. We should do it again. Check this out. It really goes with the fill. This take from this side, I started to really loosen up and I look like I'm, you know. Lior also really encouraged me to move a lot. I don't know if it started in this video, but you can tell I don't move as much today because Lior is not yelling at me most of the time. Again, not looking live, singing in one, super pissed off in the other. Meytal Cohen drums, a perfect circle, the outsider. Camera and editing by Lioron. www.lioron.com. Los Angeles, CA, March 2010. Wow. This is something special. All right, so that's it, huh? So I thought we can go over. How do you like my little fake dreads right here, by the way? Kind of cool, no? I like it. So I thought we can look at some comments. I wanted to do it on the first one I did, but then I forgot. So let's do it now. These comments, like the top comments, are really, really old. They're 10 years ago, which is crazy. But I guess we can read a few of the top comments and then read the latest comments, which might not be, I don't know if people are commenting on these videos. Let's find out. It has 600,000 views, which is, I guess, not a lot for 10 years. It's not. You should do an updated cover of this song with your current drum kit. Can't believe this was your first official drum cover. Yeah, 5 years ago, this comment, and still holds up. I should do a new cover of it, but you know what? It's just like some covers I don't want to redo because I feel like they will not be as good as the first one. And I kind of like this one. So, like, you know, even for Rush, the Rush cover that I did, I don't feel like it's good. I don't like it as much as I like the first one. There's some magic about the first one, even though I butchered half of the song, like I cut it. But I still like it better for some reason. I just, the feel of the video, the look of the video, and just, I don't know, things like that. Okay, 7 years ago, I love The Outsider because it's one of the more harder songs they have done. You do it great justice. All right, 7 years ago, such a great song, Jesus Christ.
How's it going?
Check if the camera is still on.
Hold on a second, let me.
I hope this is going well.
The camera is still on,
no
but
way
I'm gonna stop.
Bye.
Okay.
Lior just came to restart the camera just in case. Last time it turned off and I was talking to myself for like the longest time, so that's good. All right, so let's see what people currently are saying, if they're saying anything. Newest first. 3 weeks ago. Okay, this video is not completely dead. Then 2 months ago, okay, it's pretty dead. 2 months ago, 3 months ago, 4 months ago, it's pretty dead. But okay, thumbs up, horrible. Wow, thank you so much. View reply, you. That's cute. You know, when we say really bad things to others, it's usually just a reflection of our inner world. And I usually feel bad for these people, you know? They just need a hug or someone to give them unconditional love. So, yeah. All right, 2 months ago, great job on that song, girl. Fuck yeah. All right, thank you. 3 months ago, Jesus, this is freaking amazeballs. My heart rate has doubled and some. Great. I thought I loved Pull Me Under Dream Theater, but dang woman, you are super, super talented. And a reply, 4 months ago. When did you start drumming? I've always played the violin, viola, acoustic guitar. You are phenomenal. Okay, so it's the same person. When did I start drumming? I was 18 years old, and I discovered that there's a drum set in my high school. I was almost 18, I feel like. Yeah, I was still in high school. I was almost 18. And I found out that there's... I probably talked about this before. I must have. This is really close to my face. And it's... And I have like a weird light on my face that I not, that I just noticed. Oh my god. This is not good. All right. Hopefully, I should, yeah, hopefully this will not come out in video, but what are you gonna do? All right. So yeah, I started playing when I discovered that there is a music room in my high school. There was a drum set. From that moment on, apparently there was a music department, like a music, you know, in, I don't know how it is in the US, but in high school, for us, you have to choose a major. And so there was a music major. I was a theater major. And we had one class that involved music or movement. I can't remember, but it was in the room downstairs where the music department was at. And I found that there's drums. There were no sticks. But ever since I discovered that there are drums in that school, I would skip class and come with pens. Literally pens and pencils. I just learned how to play my first groove right there. All right, so apparently... because Lior is so organized, he actually saved the raw footage, the raw files from all the videos till today. Can you freaking believe it? We have the original footage from this cover. And I haven't watched it yet, and I don't know if it's gonna sound absolutely terrible. I don't know if me and Lior are already like at each other's throat. I don't know if we're like, you know, yelling at each other or what, because these were like intense. It was usually like late in the day and Lior was doing everything and was really annoyed, just kind of like today, but even more back then because we had less of a setup. So let's check out what we have here. There's quite a bit of files that we can go through, and I'm personally very excited about it. All right, let's watch. Wow, this is gold. I can't believe it. So Lior is telling me in Hebrew. Let me hear it again, actually. Sounds different. Okay, he's saying like, it doesn't matter. Well, it does matter how you're playing, but remember, there is a camera. So like, you know, do a good job, like looking and whatever, something like that. Just like, remember, there's a camera. So smile and have fun and blah, blah, blah. And I was like, okay. He's like, do, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4. I don't know what he's trying to say. It didn't inspire me. It doesn't look. Oh, that's what he meant. Like, so we can sync it properly. I had to like do that in the beginning. If you can, just do this. It's not the way I'm wired, so please help me understand. Kick ass. Ah. Oh. The skit sounds good. Mm-hmm. Oh, it's distorting as shit. Let's see what else we have here.
מהתחלה. פשוט אל תתאמצי יותר מדי. סליחה?
He's saying, don't try too hard.
נשמע רגע.
Play the snare. This is a terrible view. We were just crammed in this room, like four different bands, so we each had a corner, and I think two bands and like two drummers shared this room. Lior wants me to move the cymbals so they're like in the shot differently. I would kill him today if he tried to move my cymbal for a shot. Not a good shot. It's a very bad shot. You can't even see the snare. Can't see anything. Blister. Can't see anything.
No, so bad.
I'm saying it burns
טוב.
In a very whiny voice. And Lior's trying to pretend that
השאלה,
it cares. Wow, look at the room. What a hot mess.
אוי, סכנה שלי. פצצת. שאלה, הם דופקים עוד זווית אחת כזה שאני רץ חופשי מסביבך.
איך שאתה מרגיש?
Oh my god, look at Lior! Wow! Looks like a baby. Let's see how I did here. It's really pretty for like being a zoom, you know, guess it's a good deal. Good take, only Lior is not really shooting it. You can see it's a later take because I'm really into it and loose. He just missed the perfect take of this. Oh, jeez. Moment. This is like a signature from Michael Jackson's drummer. This is a really good take. So far. Close to being a perfect take. Wow, okay. Last one. We only have one left. Let's check it out.
Where are you going? Where are you going?
I'm going to show you around the studios.
Oh my god, I'm so awkward.
This is that too. This is room number 8. Chase is there, like, all night long recording. I got a blister, and I'm gonna wash it. It really burns.
That looks bad.
Anyways.
I was not good at vlogging back then. I was really bad. Yeah. I can't even watch it. So cringy.
Too short.
It really burns to wash the blister. That's right when it pops with soap. It does burn. But
tomorrow we have a new video.
I'm saying, so tomorrow we have a new video. I'm really awkward. Alright, yeah, I'm just uncomfortable shooting vlogs at this point. All the vlogs that I tried to shoot are cringy. That's why I ended up making them private. Anyways, you know me. I have issues. Alright, this was fun. I'm glad Lior saved all this footage, even though I gave him a hard time for buying all these hard drives. He did good. Let me know if you have any questions, if I forget to talk about something, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye.